Hey Mark, how you doing?
Good, Mike.
Now, I've been doing tricks today with half dollars and copper coins, and I thought maybe it might be time for a change. Speaking of change, do you have any in your pocket?
Yeah, I think so.
Cool. Little coins, a variety here. It's good that you got, I see quarters and nickels and pennies. And I see that you have the regular quarters and the state quarters too. And the newer state quarters are a little different than the older quarters. It's hard to tell, but they're made with different metals. As it is, the clad coins, which are the coins that they made after the silver ones, all have the different metals, the copper and the nickel and the aluminum. Well, now they're adding tungsten to the state quarters. And although they look the same, you can't really tell that much of a difference, they actually are a little softer. In fact, I noticed something else. I noticed you have some different pennies here. In fact, this is one of the newer pennies right there. I think this is the newest of all of them. And in fact, it says, 2005, so that's pretty new. I noticed that the newer pennies also, even though they seem to be copper, they're made with different metals. That's why they look like they're a little bit of a different color when you look at a bunch of them. You can put those away because we're just going to use the quarter and the penny. And I'm going to kind of put them together. And I noticed something very interesting. And that's if I squeeze them together, because they're so soft, I could actually fuse them one into the other just by pushing that penny right in there. In fact, take a look at that. You can see what I'm talking about. It's hard to get them out, but I am a magician and I can try.
Okay.
Tell you what, hold your hand palm up, because I'm going to basically hold this over your hand and I'm going to give it a little shake. If I shake it, it could actually cause that penny to actually fall right out of the coin, just like that.